One take one.
I had no idea until I was asked to do this program that there were thousands upon thousands of 3D images from World War I. I think I thought that 3D probably came in about the 1930s or 40s, but in fact by that time it had gone out of fashion, and so the photos themselves were just lying around in attics and boxes and in the corners of museums. And it's really only been in the last year or two that suddenly people have gone, oh my God, there is a whole new resource available to us which we've never even noticed. The idea of being asked to, as it were, bring all those photos to life, to curate all those photos, was something I couldn't turn down. My granddad, who fought in World War I, he came back from the war and wouldn't say anything to anybody about his experiences. So it had always been this blank, mysterious void for me, World War I. So trying to learn more about it, trying to find some sense in it, was something that I was only too keen to do. I think I had very, really quite juvenile attitudes towards the First World War. The death was madness, all of the officers were complete idiots, it should never have happened, etc. So how most of us feel, to be quite honest. Actually immersing yourself in it, I still feel that it was a dreadful war. I still think there may well have been ways whereby we didn't have to fight it, or at least not in 1914. And I still feel that a lot of the officer class weren't really up to the job, but at least I understand much more about what happened and why. And that's the best we can ask from television, really, isn't it, or factual television, that you come away just feeling you know just that little bit more.